Welcome all to the session on IoT application using Shakti processors. So here we'll be looking at building a small application that does some monitoring of weather, basically the ambient temperature and pressure. And we'll transmit the data that we measured using our sensors to a server in the cloud. So what do we need to build this application? One, we need a Shakti processor, and then we'll use BMP280, which is a sensor that senses the temperature and the pressure. And we'll use ESP8266, which has a Wi-Fi module in it. And we'll be using the Wi-Fi modem in it to transmit the data to the server in the cloud. And then to build the application, we'll be needing a toolchain, which would convert our programs to our binaries. And then the software development kit will provide you the interfaces to talk to the peripherals in the board. Next, we'll need a PCB or a breadboard. So to connect the sensors to the processor, we'll use a breadboard. And then we'll have a power supply and wires to do the connection, and a Wi-Fi to get a connectivity to the internet. Let's briefly look at the Shakti processor that we'll be using here. So here we'll be using a processor called Parashu. So this is a Shakti E-class processor, which would run on RT-A700T board. So in this application, we'll be using BMP280. So this is the sensor can be used both as an SPI or an I2C sensor. So in our application, we'll use it in I2C. Next, we have ESP8266. This is a Wi-Fi module. We'll be using the Wi-Fi modem in this module to communicate to the server. We'll be using AT commands to the Wi-Fi modem in this module to connect and send data. Shakti is a RISC-V based architecture. It uses RISC-V toolchain to develop software. So in the Shakti tools, we have ready to use RISC-V tools. So the Shakti SDK is a C or C++ platform to develop applications over Shakti. The SDK has necessary firmware code and a framework to develop new applications on the hardware. So this framework is lightweight, and it can also be customized, and it's also open source. So next, look at the setup that will be used for this application. So we have a BMP280 sensor, which will connect to the I2C ports. And we have an ESP8266, which will connect to the UART. And through this UART, we'll send AT commands to the ESP8266 Wi-Fi modem, and then send the data across to the server in the cloud. Before we can read the values from the sensor, we need to initialize it. So first thing is, like, this FPGA board has a clock rate of 50 megahertz. So to bring down the clock rate to be suitable for the sensor, we'll configure the clock rate by using the prescale and the SCL registers. Then we'll have to set the address of the sensor. So the BMP280 has a predefined address value, which we'll be configuring on the using it to communicate with that in the I2C peripheral. Next, once we get the set address, we'll have to find out whether we are able to communicate it to it. So we'll first detect the sensor. BMP280 has a set of registers which would give calibration values. So once we read a particular temperature from the sensor, we'll use the calibration values to get the accurate or the correct information. And then to initialize the ESP8266 module, first we'll tell the processor that we'll be using UART1, wherein UART0 is used for communicating between our system and the board to load a program or to debug a program. So UART 1 and 2 are the ones which we can use it for to connect to an external interface. Next, we'll use we'll set the baud rate. So here we'll be using baud rate of 115200, and then we'll set the Wi-Fi mode on the ESP8266. Basically, we'll set it as a client. 8266 can act as a client or a server, mix of both. But in this case, we just want it to act as a client alone. Next, we'll configure the SSID and the password to connect to a particular access point. So here are a set of commands that we'll use to transmit the pressure and the temperature values. So we'll use the AT commands again here. So AT SIP start will give the protocol and the URL that we want to connect to. And then next we'll tell to the modem like how long the length of the data is going to be, and then we will send the data to the server. So here when we use thingspeak.com, it basically provides a key using which it identifies a particular channel number. So whatever we data we send, it will be updated to this particular channel number, and it could get processed and displayed there. So finally, once we complete the transmission, it's a SIP close to close the connection.
Well, now we'll look at how do we make build the program and then run it from the terminal. So let me go back to my terminal. Now we are in Shakti SDK folder where we have cloned the Shakti SDK. So here we see we have the BSP folder which has all the drivers and the board related code, and then also we have the software wherein we will have the examples and the projects. So we'll just quickly look at what are there in the examples. So examples has for each of the peripheral types, there are set of applications that you have written, which can be used as a reference to build your own application. And under projects, we have, these are the projects that we have provided as a sample. Now we'll build the weather station that's using BMP280. Okay. Now that it's successfully built, we will connect through OpenOCD, and also we'll start running the program. So as we see in the slide, so we'll open two terminals, one to connect to the OpenOCD and another one to connect to our GDB to load our program. So for ease of use, I'm just going back to the root folder of the Shakti SDK. So this ftda.cfg file has the configs related to how to connect to this board using OpenOCD. Now we have connected to that. Next, I'll open another terminal wherein I will use RISC-V GDB. So now I have told GDB two things. One, I've given a path to a GDB script, which basically sets up what is the port it has to connect to the OpenOCD, and then what is the program that we have to load into the board. So next we'll use the command load. So this loads up the program into a RAM of the Next, we'll use the continue command to start executing it. Once it starts executing, we can see the output or it getting and the values getting updated in the thingspeak.com website. Now we see the values getting updated as soon as we transmit from through ESP8266. It gets updated in the thingspeak.com site in our channel.